Slate.
New Rory Mal, Patreon episode 680. Me lucky lad. Welcome to a new episode of the new Rory and Mal podcast.
Wow.
He's a proper lad.
Are you a character in Harry Potter? What the fuck? You Dumbledore?
I'm sorry, I just got in spirit. I don't know what happened. I just got in spirit. Welcome to a new episode of the new Rory and Mal podcast. I am Mal.
I am Rory.
And today is a special... special day for you, Rory. Listen, today is St. Patrick's Day.
Son of Swords.
Hey. This is St. Patty's Day. This is the day to celebrate the Irish people, our Irish brothers and sisters around the world. So today we are being very festive. I got my first chain a day.
Yeah.
I'm still waiting for Jay and Biggs to give me a rock chain. But I got a...
Welcome to the Irish team.
I got a lucky clover. Woo!
Well, you know what's fucked up about this? Now that the clovers are like the popping thing that the IG chicks wear, you would look like you're wearing fake jewelry, right?
Yeah, this is the fake. This is the Van Cleef. This is the Van
Cleef. Like, you know,
Van Cleefs.
You don't think that's cultural appropriation either?
I do. I side with you on this one, Rory. I do think that that's cultural appropriation.
This entire day is making me very uncomfortable. How everyone is dressed.
What do you mean?
Me wearing this.
What are we dressed? Like,
there's a camera now. They can all see.
What's wrong with how we're dressing?
You have on glasses with no lens.
That's not the point of it.
Listen, prescription. Before we get into that, I just want to let everybody know that next February for Black History Month, you all will be wearing dashikis for the entire month. Even though it's winter, I want you all in dashiki and sandals every day.
Okay. Would you like me to kneel like the Democrats when
absolutely.
I wear mine?
Yes. Okay. I want you to kufis, dashikis. We're going to be eating fufu, all kind of shit for the entire month.
Okay.
To celebrate Black History.
Next Black History Month, can I do this?
No, next Black History Month, you'll be fired. So you don't have to worry about that.
He might be fired now.
Yeah.
I think.
Can we skip, Cinco de Mayo for Eden after that?
No, because
this
Rory's
is all racist.
Right there.
You know what, Dame? I fully understand. Once I see my culture being appropriated, I finally fucking get it. This is Lior Cohen. You are all Lior Cohen to me right now. This is fucking nuts. Take those fucking glasses off. I'm taking this off. This is stupid. This is my culture. It's way more than fucking light up shit. Listen. And drinking Irish carbon. This is ridiculous. This is the Todd Moskowitz of my culture.
I thought that was a pretty cool.
Well, can
cool
you enlighten us a little on your culture?
Yeah, what is your culture, Rory?
Well, when we walked in here, Julian started making what he called Irish car bombs. I thought that was racist.
Yep.
Never mind. Make the joke.
He just started making them, and he's Lebanese.
Time.
I figured that, you know, they make the best, most effective car bombs.
Yeah.
And he stayed in the car when the bomb went off.
Yeah.
It's one word away from a news headline.
Listen, man. I'm just trying to show you my appreciation to your culture
Julian
today. I got the green on for you.
I'm meeting racism by countering it with more racism.
Okay,
there you go.
It's all good. But happy St. Patrick's Day to all the Irish people around the world. All of our Irish listeners, Rory,
and you all have your 23andMe's. You all have Irish in you.
We do.
We were horse. We do. Everyone has some type of Irish.
Definitely.
Or now
Irish in me for sure.
Well, how's the family feeling about? I know y'all are celebrating this weekend.
It's been a big week.
Yeah, it's a
got
big
a big week,
week
ahead. You know, dad coming into town.
Not Christmas.
No.
Nope.
Not a christening. Nothing like that, right?
No.
It's fucking St.
Patrick's Day. Yes.
Right? Just getting drunk?
You're a proper lad.
What do you guys think St. Patrick's Day is about?
I don't know.
Like, from outside looking in.
Well, as a New Yorker, it's just very loud. A lot of alcohol.
Yeah.
A lot of traffic.
Yeah.
And a lot of arrests. A lot of people spending the night in the tank. Central bookings.
How do you think you would do at the Staten Island parade?
You kill it.
There's the one on Fifth Avenue.
Yeah, no, I want to go to the real one. Not the politically correct one. I want to go where the fights are happening.
You want to know about Irish culture?
Yeah, yeah.
Go to Staten Island and go to that parade.
that's the one I want to go to. I've never been to that one. I've heard a lot of great things about it, though.
Great things, right?
Yeah, great things. Great things. I love Irish people.
Rory, have you ever worn a kilt?
No, I have not. but... I do want to take back.
He's worn a kith, though.
Hey.
A kith kilt?
Yeah, kith kilt.
You would.
That would eat.
I do want to take bagpipe lessons, though.
That would eat.
So I would wear a kilt if I did
that. What is the bagpipe? What is that? Is that?
Oh, you want to learn how to blow?
Is that like a...
I'm really trying to learn about your culture here.
And he's trying to make jokes about your culture.
Yeah.
So is the bagpipes, is that like playing a bunch of flutes? Is it the same as the flute?
Sort of.
Skin flute.
From my understanding, the history... Does it used to be the stomach of a lamb or some shit like that is what the bag used to be and how they actually used to play that instrument. It's a bag of some animal. Yeah. Listen, man. Potatoes took us out, so we were dealing with what we had.
Yeah.
We had to make instruments out of whatever at that point.
But out of a lamb's stomach is
I'm pretty sure. That's where it does come from. Of course, we probably weren't the creators. I'm sure we stole it from someone.
Yeah. Actually, I think y'all might have created this one. This might be y'all thing.
Well, I have to give, as much as I'm not a big fan of the Scottish, they have some rights to bagpipes as well. I can't say it's just the Irish thing. Mm-hmm. I think we took it mainstream. I think like if you're an underground hip hop fan, you'd fuck with the Scottish. But we're like Puff.
Okay.
The Irish are Puff when it comes to the bagpipes.
Got you.
Scottish are more like MF Doom with it. Oh. If I were to put it in a
comparison. No, I like that.
Yeah, still contributes to the culture the same, one is just more mainstream.
Right.
That's all.
Got you. Okay.
Have you guys done a parade ever?
Yeah, I've actually been part of the marching band at Cardinal Hayes. Shout out to
Oh, nice. Hayes. Yeah, I know Cardinal Hayes does it every year.
Yeah, so then we did that. And that was very interesting. It'd be a lot of drunk Irish people.
What were you playing?
I played clarinet.
I play clarinet.
Yeah, I'm not very proud of saying that out loud.
You look like you played a clarinet.
Yeah.
Everything makes sense now. Everything makes sense now.
Yeah.
You have the carrying? You did not bring that case on the concourse.
Yeah.
Oh, you got chased.
Yeah.
Oh, them niggas on 167 chased you all the way to Tremont. Yeah, I know they did.
That was fun. No, but we would do the parade on 5th.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that was fun. There'd be a lot of drunk Irish women trying to talk to high schoolers. Mm. So that was weird.
It's on par.
Very weird. Yeah. But sounds about right.
Par for the course.
Yeah.
Julian was very hyped for this day. I don't know. He texted chat last night. He had a whole bunch of it would look like an Irish kidnapping kit. He had bottles of Guinness on the bed, glasses, hats. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck he was doing last night.
I have a very dirty 18 plus story about St. Patrick's Day that I'm going to save for Patreon.
Ooh.
That involves bagpipes.
Oh.
You have a dirty story, 18 plus.
You can dress up as a monkey and be fed.
Yeah, so
what the fuck is
hilarious.
That?
Hilarious. Wait till you see it. It's fucking crazy.
What is going on? I feel like I don't think the world is a simulation, seriously. Yeah, I don't think like there's somebody with a joystick above all of us controlling us like.
Yeah, the aliens.
Yeah, some people say God, but you know.
I would say the Jews.
There's no way this world is real. There's no way. Like, this is not a real experience we're having.
It's just another dimension of another dimension of another dimension of a thought of another dimension.
And then he
it's kind of like when you look at yourself in the mirror and some mirror behind you, and you can see yourself and yourself behind you.
This is just one layer of a bigger thought.
Ah,
got it. Much bigger thought. That's why we really don't matter that much.
We don't?
Like, as much as I'd love to say that Dre is pregnant. Oh, hey, Patreon. Welcome back. We're here. Apologies for the last episode. Things got off the rails.
Why are you apologizing?
Yeah, y'all showed y'all ass when I walked out the door.
That's why we showed our ass, because you walked out the door.
We did go kind of crazy when she left. Even though I was like, at one point calling socialism, communism, which I think they are the same, but it's fine. My point still stood in what I was trying to say.
Yeah.
But I know I was wrong in that way. I just feel socialism has a lot of, anyways, doesn't matter.
Nope.
It went off the fucking rails. I know some people loved it. I know some people hated it.
They hated you.
But welcome.
They hated me?
Hell yeah.
They hated on Jesus.
Though. Yes.
I gotta think about that.
There you go. That's why you my dog.
I
love when people hate me. I love that shit.
You gotta remember what they did to Jesus.
Yeah.
Anytime somebody hates.
And since I'm made in the image and likeness of Christ himself.
White Jesus.
That means that I'm right on par. There you go. You know what I'm saying?
It's a long episode.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. You know. You were born in Israel?
No, I was born in Beth Israel.
That was a good one.
That was actually great.
I actually don't know what hospital I was born in. I forgot.
Yeah. What?
Look at your birth certificate.
They probably tore it down.
Damn, that I gotta ask my mom.
In the back of that horse and buggy.
Born in a fucking manger.
Damn, I forgot what hospital I was born in. That's crazy.
Some straw grass.
You went searching our truth back in the yard.
How did I arrive?
How did I arrive?
Where did I arrive?
Where do they keep horses? What's that thing called?
A stable?
Yeah, it was an empty stable.
Yeah.
Your mother knocked on the door.
They call them that too.
Yeah, I gotta call my mom. She's gonna like want to hang up on me because I ask her that probably every like 5 years.
Yeah, because you start with the witch bitches that want to do your birth chart.
Oh, no, my mom don't even answer that no more. She be like, yo, stop talking to her. She'll text me back, stop talking to that girl.
Is your birth certificate etched in stone?
Yeah, I think so. Mm. I think it's like a slab of concrete somewhere in my mom's closet.
You got to throw some water on it.
Yeah, to see it. To see it, like, yeah.
Social security number is only 4 digits.
That's crazy. If your social security number is 4 digits,
you're dead.
Do you guys remember that? What was that theory that white people had like even numbers at the end of their social security number?
Two numbers in the middle are always when you add them up, it's even if you're black, and it's odd if you're not, if you're white.
I'm sure there's some mathematical science to it where there's there to keep track of people in mine's, this regard.
Well, you said the two middle numbers?
Yeah.
If they add up.
If they're an even number when you add them up, you're black. If they're not, that means you're.
Damn, I'm black then.
Mine,
mine's eight. If you add mine up,
mine's
eight.
Six.
Yours is six?
Yeah. So there goes that theory. That
debunks our
as white as they come, 23 and me told me.
Yeah.
Couldn't even get that one like South African percent. Anyways, off mic, they were trying to explain.
No. Is it that or is it an even number?
I think it's bullshit is what I think the theory makes absolutely no sense.
All right, what's your middle numbers?
All right, man.
No, tell me the rest.
Just your middle numbers of your social security? You can't say just the middle numbers? It's like...
It adds up to six and it's all right, two but numbers.
Is it like, if it's like 51, then there might be some theory.
It's six and zero.
Oh, so that's an even number. Okay.
Yeah, I said it added up to six. And is zero an even number? Yeah.
Well, 60 is an even number.
There you go.
Yeah.
Well, they were trying to explain to us off mic.
Julian, what the fuck?
Yeah, what are you doing over here?
This thing is, it's annoying me, and I noticed in the last episode.
We had just pre-production
right
for this.
Right now while we're recording. It was just necessary.
Thank you.
Is
he okay?
I don't know.
Sorry.
Drugs.
It looks a lot cleaner.
I think he might be back. Off the wagon.
Yeah. You had a little blow night?
No. Stop.
He said stop. That's a stop. Yes.
Yeah, that's a yes.
guys, stop.
So how'd you know? How'd you know? Yeah. Can you see it in my eyes?
All right, good.
And we're back. Don't edit any of that. Keep everything so people know we have to deal with when we don't. This is a behind the scenes look, Patreon exclusive.
Yo, so I was watching Society.
A new newest. Nuclear episode of the new Rory Mal podcast.
Did you just say the new N-word?
I said the new N-word. I'm sorry. I apologize. Welcome to a new episode of the new Rory Mal podcast. I am Mal.
I'm Rory.
And we are back to talk to you beautiful people. Good morning, good afternoon, good night, depending on where you are in the world, Rory.
Yes.
Hopefully you had your bacon, egg, and cheese, your green tea, your chamomile, whatever you're eating or drinking on your way to work to go make the white man rich, Rory.
All right.
Got to get up every morning.
Off to the races.
Got
to
get up every morning and make the white man rich.
Pork white and white men.
There
that's,
you go.
That's our intro.
Got to start your day with swine and divine. How you guys doing? Y'all look good. Y'all look good. Julian, you look good.
Had a good
haircut.
Week.
Extra moves in the hair. No. What's that gorilla snot? I know gorilla snot when I see it.
No. If you really know about the gorilla snot, that's
come on,
really
uptown. We don't do that. You know, I'm from uptown. No, I'm from those Mexican places.
Yeah,
same thing.
It sounds racist, but go ahead.
Gorilla snot.
Yeah. I use
just keep going.
You don't know about gorilla snot?
I use gorilla snot.
You do?
That's, you do?
Yeah.
Who named that?
What do you mean?
Like, who approved that name?
Because it was like gorilla glue is like a strong form of glue.
I'm right? aware, yeah.
So the gorilla people, they made gorilla snot with the hair.
Who are got gorilla you. People,
no, it's not you the people. Same people. They're
who are
same.
Gorilla people?
Wait, you're about to tell me that the gorilla glue people are also in hair products?
No. Yeah.
Absolutely. Owner of the market. Lying.
Speaking of products.
No, that's how that girl fucked
gorillas,
her hair
mooses,
time.
I can't keep up.
Speaking gorilla of products, snot. Can we talk about how Damaris has a Fiji bottle filled with wine?
I think it's
why
classy.
Did you do that?
This isn't wine.
That's wine.
This is my brain juice.
Brain juice? Explain yeah. further.
That's why.
Yeah, let's I talk about it. This brain juice.
Brain juice is my favorite
kind of
juice.
You gotta have a good cup of brain juice.
I have ADHD.
When she has
so
that
this
brain
helps
juice?
My brain like focus. Yeah.
Oh, okay. What's in the brain juice that helps you focus?
Wine.
It's not wine.
Yeah. Sauvignon Blanc.
What is that? A barefoot? What is that?
Barefoot?
Barefoot brain juice?
Yeah, barefoot Moscato.
Barefoot brain juice yeah. right there.
Moscato.
Clap, clap, bravo.
Y'all really think so little of me.
Oh, man. This is the craziest bunch in podcasting, bro. I promise you it is. How y'all feeling? Are y'all good?
We're okay.
Oh, Yomi, yeah. you good? I love Yomi's energy. She's just like a fly on the wall.
Yeah.
She's just like here, hanging out, just like whatever. I'm capturing the moment.
She knows
Eddie,
too
how
much.
You doing, man? You look good.
You look good.
Thank you, man. I saw a flyer you have.
Can we put it in the lower
can
third?
Can we insert the flyer? Yeah,
it's not a flyer.
And I just want to let you know I support you. And one day I am going to pull up to one of your parties. I just don't
it's not a flyer.
Can we?
It is a flyer.
It's a motion graphic about a mix I did for Heavy Hits.
It's an experience. It's not a flyer.
Not a plug.
Graphic?
Nasty plug.
Sorry, I have something to plug.
It's called a motion graphic. Is that shots. What it's called?
Motion graphic, yeah.
Motion graphic. So
here it is.
I'm scrolling through Instagram and I saw motion. I saw two Eddins. I thought Eddin was debuting his twin brother to the world.
Shout out to Schuler for making this.
And I'm like, oh, this is Eddin, but like two different looks.
Yeah.
This is like his sophisticated, I mean, business.
What?
Look. Mm-hmm. Oh, and then he has his
is
t-shirt.
Is that a corduroy button up?
Like, get you a man that can do both.
Yeah, that's what that is. So,
certified Lomo boy.
This is a, what are you doing here? Is this a, a show, a podcast?
So I used to work for this record pool called heavyhits.com. Shout out to them. And I did an exclusive mix for them that's available on Mixcloud right now.
This looks
an
like you're about to pimp someone's ride.
Look at Loyon's comment.
So what? Fire emojis. Oh my God.
Thank you, Loyon. I appreciate it.
Gotta hit Julian though. What? He looks like he's about to pimp someone's ride.
You didn't hear Eden. I did an exclusive mix.
I did. The one and only available.
So this warranted extra. Like, yo, you get one Eden, but that's just not enough. Is this the mix? Are they mixing you?
They're mixing me.
This is you on the turntable.
That's me going round and round.
Oh my
round
God. Eden, I just love you, man. I look forward
I
to
hate that corduroy
Eden
button
so
up.
I just love Eden.
You
so
hate
much
the corduroy
I
button?
I hate that.
Hate is a strong word.
You hate what?
His corduroy button up.
Nah, that's what he's supposed to wear.
That's the swag.
Yeah. That's his swag. That's his, you know what I mean? That's how he coming into the party and he take that off, show you the t-shirt under it, and that means he's getting into the full mix. It's party time now.
You want to know what the t-shirt says?
What does it say?
Kind of hate it. It says one of one.
Can I eat it?
But there's two of you.
It says one of one. Yeah, there's two of me.
One of two.
One of two.
Oh, God.
Did you choose both those images?
No. The one with the hated button down. Yeah, I did.
Do you have like a folder that's like just for flyers?
I do.
Of course you do.
Don't
did you? Did you send notes on this? Like, nah, no, let it rotate a little faster.
He just said that to me this morning. I was like, fuck it.
He was like, let it put it out.
Yeah.
And you picked that aesthetic, that color, the pink.
No, they
choose
that
with the rest of his page.
It goes with the heavy hits colors.
This looks like if the H&M on 42nd Street had a bisexual section specific for clothing.
Because there's two of them.
And this would be the ad. Yeah.
That's a very fluid button up.
That's a fluid button up?
Eden looks like he puts the pinstripes on the cars.
For sure.
He does what?
I put the pinstripes on the cars. He's trying to say.
He's really into cooking, so we're going to put a whole stove in his trunk.
We don't talk about Pimp My Ride enough.
Oh, I love it.
Thank iconic God show. But there needed to be a follow-up of all those cars. Like, they need to go back to all the same people, and we need to see how long any of that.
Yeah, I want to see the Pimp My Ride cars now, today.
They're probably all fucked up.
Scrapyard.
Like, I want to see them today. Like,
they had,
the one,
like, PS2s in it.
I'm dying to see the one that had the fish tank in it.
I was going
to
say, imagine getting in a car
like
crash.
What do you think is in that fish tank right now? Like,
car.
what is in that fish tank right now? Like, today.
They should have just followed every car for about an hour just to see the potholes and what they did afterwards.
They meant well. It was a great concept to take a car that was kind of beat up and then turn it into like this futuristic.
No more.
Great concept.
They took people with shitty cars and took them from shitty cars to liabilities.
Yeah.
That's they just added more bullshit to these people's lives.
That's
what kind of, yeah.
Great show though. Iconic show. Yeah.
Shout out to happening. You see they're doing I Am Legend 2.
Are they?
They are?
That was announced, yeah.
Oh, wow. Pull it up.
They better not ruin
that,
my favorite
that, now,
movie.
That I want to see.
10 years later.
I Am Legend is one of my favorite movies. I think it was an amazing movie.
It was a great movie. Great movie. I love I Am Legend.
That's one of the movies that anytime it's on, I watch it.
I watch it too, yeah.
Same. And Will was in 90% of the movie, he was by himself, and somehow it was still an amazing movie.
It was
and
a really
they need
movie
to give my man his props for that.
No, great Will, movie. Will's I love that movie.
Well, apparently Michael B is going to be in it.
Oh, never
come
mind
on.
Michael B. Jordan?
Mm-hmm.
Why y'all hate Michael B. Jordan?
Yeah, what's wrong
so
with Michael B. Jordan? Now he's never going to be on the show.
Michael B. Jordan can act. You don't think he can act?
You saw Creed 1 and 2.
He's directing 3.
There I like go him in Creed more than anything else he's ever played.
He acts in Creed.
He fights in Creed.
Does he have like 3 lines?
Oh, I guess. Sure.
That's fucked up that y'all don't think. I think Michael B. Jordan's a decent
yeah
guy.
You guys
I
are giving
decent is fucking hilarious.
What was the movie he was in? What was the movie he was in with Jamie Foxx? He played the lawyer?
Have Mercy?
Yeah.
There you
I
go
thought he did a great job in that movie.
See?
I liked Have Mercy.
Yeah. He was in Black Panther?
I thought he did a great job.
He was horrible in Black Panther. He ruined the movie for me.
I still, to this day, have not seen
Black Panther. He's in Black Panther?
Of course you
that's
haven't.
That's racist.
Are you dead ass?
Oh, the first one.
I have not
sorry,
seen
I thought you meant, yeah, I've seen
Marvel. Wait, hold on. I didn't mean it like that. I meant like the Marvel comic.
What do you mean by any of those movies?
I didn't mean those movies.
What do you mean?
No, I didn't mean
those
movies.
When you say those movies,
no, I meant like the comic book.
Like any of the Ryan Coogler movies, one of the greatest
Ryan what
directors ever.
I can't be racist. I like Tyler Perry movies.
Okay,
which one?
Oh my God, you can be, that's actually
the most racist.
It's the most racist.
Speaking of Tyler Perry, he has a movie that I saw on Netflix that was really good. I don't know if I told you about it. A Jazz Man's Blues.
No.
You get a chance to watch that. If you get a chance to watch that, it was a really good movie. Really good movie. Mm-hmm. I think I mentioned it on the podcast before. A Jazz Man's Blues on Netflix. Check it out if you haven't. Really good Tyler Perry movie.
I Am Legend 2007 that came out. Wow.
Jesus Christ.
Not that long
that age.
When is part two coming out?
Oof, probably in a year or two.
My best friend got fingered in that movie.
in the movie. Your best friend was in
Legend. That's actually a really good category to talk about for a topic one day. Maybe a Patreon.
No, like movies, during the while she was in theaters or like in the movie?
No, not in the
movie. I'm about to say, what part of the movie was that?
She was one of the aliens.
That's what I'm about to say.
You said in the movie.
She got fingered.
I'm sorry. In the movie theater.
I understood what you were saying.
Thank you.
During the movie, the woman was fingered.
Context clues matter.
No, but what you literally said was she got fingered in the movie.
I was like, what?
Like they were like, all right, cut. And she just like,
I was like, she was like, what?
All you hear is macaroni and cheese.
If you think about it though, at the end of I Am Legend, when they get to like the Oasis or whatever,
yeah,
definitely people getting fingered in that bubble.
Exactly.
Okay. What? They was definitely fucking in that bubble. They had to get the population back.
Yeah. Yeah, they did.
Oh my God. Would y'all like sign up? Well, actually, I don't. I'm asking men, and of course, men don't care. I wish I had a woman to ask.
There's a woman right there.
If you would want to participate in recreating
Earth?
Yes.
Hell yeah.
Repopulating Earth. Of course, you guys were, because you're men. You don't have to actually have the fucking children.
So you just want to know, you're just asking if a woman would like to give birth.
Essentially.
I don't know if that's fully what was asked, but all right.
The bottom line.
Can we think about this reality show or even scripted series of like the bubble that is after I Am Legend, where there's only like 30 people and you have to keep the population going, how shady it would get in there?
Shady.
Like, no, I would like, I'll fuck her, but like, I can tell she's a little, has some mental health problems. Yeah, I don't want my bloodline. Because we're going to restart the bloodline. Yeah. I'm going to be the new Chase.
Yeah.
Like, I'm going to be the new
Rockefeller?
Yeah, like, that's going to be my legacy. I can't fuck her.
But that's why you got to go on a speed date.
Speed dating in the I Am Legend.
In the I Am Legend bubble, yeah. To repopulate.
5 minutes and you figure out y'all know.
Like, what part of town you from? Any kids?
No. Well, the part of town becomes the bubble. Like, what part of the bubble you in? Oh, you're downtown? I'm not. I can't really fuck with you.
Yeah. Castle Hill? Mm-mm.
Where you from? Co-op City? Nah. You from? Section 3?
Would you have some pressure on you, though? Knowing that you would be, the Clays would be
the
new Rockefellers, like, for real this time.
Mm-hmm. Would it be any pressure?
For real this time?
For real. That's funny. Like, for real. That's
like, all, for real.
I know y'all like, so get you the name, but like...
Like you have a responsibility to get the population going, so I think everyone in the bubble would understand, like, we all just need to fuck each other.
Yeah,
because we have to get the shit moving.
Gotta get these numbers up.
Yeah. But you thinking about your last name specifically, you can't have a bunch of Clays running around that ain't like beans in them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you gotta change the A beans from the hard ER.
I am looking forward to I Am Legend 2, though. I do want to see a part 2 to this. It's interesting to see what song? It is.
Drop that beat.
Known as nuclear.
Drop that new hit.
Nuclear is so devastating that
Mortimer.
We don't even want to talk about it.
We're back. We're back, Julian.
Oh my God.
They tried to break us up.
I said that once. I said, oh, what a terrible thing.
Look at the Don.
You have two N-words.
We have two.
The one is, but the other is the nuclear word.
Yeah.
Not supposed to ever be mentioned.
I don't know if y'all knew it was two.
Ever. It's mentioned every single day now.
I see the comparison.
Come on, don't do that. Like, Don, he's dropping balls for you.
The old one used to be mentioned every day, too.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Elon let it fly.
This world has never seen. This will make World War I and World War II.
Well, he's an alien, like, so it doesn't really matter his race.
Yeah.
Like baby stuff.
Baby stuff.
Known as nuclear.
You, baby.
Your boy's back, Maul.
Your boy's back.
I will say, Trump knows how to keep a hit record. Like, he knows this is the first single from the last album was Mexicans Are Rapists.
What happened?
This is the first single to the new album.
What happened was he started seeing people like, yo, where's Donald Trump? He's been kind of quiet. He's not. This is just, you know, this is his way of just shaking up the algorithms.
Yeah.
Two N words. Two that we should never say.
Mm-hmm.
We know what the first one is.
What's the first one?
The first one is.
Okay, gotta bleep that.
So. Can't say.
Well, all right.
Trump's other favorite word.
Trump's definitely one of his faves. But this nuclear. It's just nuclear.
It's what?
It's the delivery, too.
Yeah.
Nuclear.
His Adderall ass mouth.
That dry ass mouth, that chalk mouth. Can't say it. Not supposed to say it. Now we just say it every day.
That was really good.
We have two N words. You know what the one is, and the other is
nuclear.
Nuclear.
Huh? Oh, okay. I thought you were looking at me. I was trying to stay on this segment.
Like here.
We do have three N words. Welcome to a new episode of the new Rory and Mal podcast.
Nuclear Rory and Mal.
The nuclear Rory. The nuclear Rory and Mal podcast.
Say the other one.
Nah,
I'm not gonna say it.
Not the first 5 minutes.
Yeah, not gonna say it. Nuclear Rory and Mal podcast. I am Mal.
So you're fine with the N-word just as long as it's not in the first 5 minutes of a video.
Exactly.
Well, his N-word is Nicaragua.
Thank you.
Which I can't say either. Yeah. He's too many root words in there that you know.
It's three
N-words. He's from Central America.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
like alphabetical slaughter.
The Papoose song?
Every day, man.
It took me a second. I was like, wait,
every day I don't understand.
He can't be talking about the Papoose song.
I just don't understand this group of people we have in this room.
As someone that does like Papoose, we put a lot of sauce on that record.
Yo, first of all, look, who else? What other podcast are you going to go from Trump to Papoose? Look at us.
Like, we really sat there like he just fucking invented fire.
You did.
He was like, hey, alert.
And like, it was the first time I like remember being, whether it was school, barbershop or whatever, like people trying to break down obvious shit to you. Like, you don't understand. He went from A to B. I'm like, nah, I know the alphabet.
But you've never slaughtered the alphabet though.
That is very true.
Yeah. So he was the first one to slaughter it.
Well, that's what Trump is doing now, because before there was one N-word.
Yeah.
So now we have to get rid of another N-word.
There's a few N-words.
He's slaughtering the alphabet.
This episode is dedicated to all of the N-words that we have to just get away, that we have to put away. We can't use them anymore. We just got to put them away. So as we go through this episode and this sound journey, Rory, let's come up with N-words.
Look at the F-word that Papoose used during the F segment.
Oh, yeah. Fake fraud.
Fake fraud. Ah. Then he said something. Yeah. Front for fame.
Then he said something. Can't say that word anymore.
He said a lot.
Yeah.
Trump can. I think Trump is going to get the F word off.
Him or Elon? I told you guys that Elon, he sent me I went up my Twitter app the other day, and before I could use it, I had to delete some old tweets from 2009 that I didn't make that a friend of mine grabbed my phone. That's what used to happen.
Yeah, we know.
And I forgot I didn't delete those, so I had to delete them. Mm-hmm. And now I have my account back.
It's weird that Elon knows those specific words.
Well, you know, he sent the guys to search and clean up those Twitter streets.
Yeah.
But we are back with a nuclear episode. I am Mal.
I'm Rory.
And we are, well, you know, we just have to make sure that people know who's who and what's what around these parts. Donald Trump made first of all, it's been a few days since we've all seen each other. So.
The heart over his sword tattoo was hilarious. This was a really, really well done video. But you still didn't answer how your body count would handle this, Robert. Right.
Well, first of all, we're going to need a bigger boat.
Talk your shit. Mr. Bitches over here.
Was that a Jaws reference?
No, but listen, let me just put this out here. I definitely not have been with more women than Drake. Let's put that out here, number one. I think that these are probably supposed to kind of... He's supposed to be maybe the girls that he was going to be proposed to, maybe.
Yeah. Well, I would assume he would have fucked them.
Well, where did y'all get that idea from? Nobody ever said that.
He did.
That what?
Yeah.
He said that about the diamonds. He said that about the video.
Oh no, he didn't say that about. We're just podcasting.
Damn, man.
Just a podcast.
Fuck.
You don't see the deeper meaning of this.
So
you just on the surface level.
Yeah, dive in more.
We're below the surface. You're just on the boat.
Yeah.
We're down.
See, that's why they ain't tell you to get on the yacht.
We're in the galley.
You couldn't see that far.
Yeah, rock. Mal.
The Leah.
There you go.
What?
I don't know. Eden just gets into these modes where he just starts like getting vomit, diarrhea of the mouth, and he just goes. I don't know what he's talking about. But great video. Who directed this? Do we know? If I'm willing to guess, Dave Myers?
I think it was Dave Myers.
What I told you. That was just a guess. It feels like Dave. Looks like... Pause. Looks like Dave.
Feels like Dave.
Yeah, that's how I said pause.
Oh, this looks like a Nathan production for sure. Thank God Nathan produced this.
Thank you, Nathan.
Thank God for Nathan.
And you know, like, Lark is the only director representative
I knew this was a Dave Myers. It feels like an old school hip hop video.
I'm with you. And shout out to Fatima, 21's stylist. Just going to go through the credits.
I love Fatima. She's dope.
I've never met a whack Fatima now that I think about it. We have to add that name to the
Fatima is definitely a name. When you hear Fatima, she's into some cool shit.
Yeah.
Fatima's always cool. I never met a Fatima that didn't have some cool shit going on. Like, if you see a Fatima that like don't have cool shit going, she changed her name to Fatima.
Yeah.
That wasn't like her birth given name.
That's her Instagram name.
Yeah.
In the video, like you mentioned, Drake gets killed, shot in the head and thrown overboard. Have you ever felt like your life or safety was threatened by an ex or a girl that you were talking to?
Not to that extent, no. The most I thought was going to happen was maybe like show up and just cause a scene at like the crib, kicking on the door or something. Not kill. Yeah, that. Shorty was banging on her head. But that was like, it was a conversation, which is why that's crazy, because it was a conversation. And then she started just banging on her head. And I was like, I don't think you should do that, but it's your head. Like,
just feel like.
Yeah, do what you want.
You're giving concussion vibes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, you should not be doing that. But if that's how you get your anger out, get your shit off.
I would say the closest thing, I don't like when women play in the car. Like, when you're arguing and I'm driving, like, relax a little bit.
Yeah.
Like, this push is, you? This could compromise. Yes.
Yeah.
A chick ever pulled a wheel on you?
One time, what? And it wasn't in an argument. She might have been high. I was really maybe 21. And she grabbed the 21. Wheel. I don't know if she was drunk, high. She just thought it was funny.
What was your reaction?
What the fuck are you doing?
Were you on like a highway?
I mean, I still beat. Don't get me wrong.
A city road or a freeway?
That didn't.
I was on 1 and 9 in Elizabeth, New Jersey.
Nice.
I remember it vividly. And I was driving a camera truck that I had stolen? I was supposed to put. It was a 3-day shoot, and it was supposed to go in a bonded lot.
It said stolen.
But I'm like,
why did she do that?
I don't know. I think she was just psychotic, and I have a type.
She
grabbed the wheel.
No, we weren't arguing. Everything was fine. She was just like, ha ha, and like did that. I was like, what the fuck are you doing?
Nah, you can't ha ha and follow it up with pulling the steering wheel while I'm driving. That's not a ha ha.
I'm not exaggerating this at all. That's exactly what happened.
I don't know. Like, because I don't have crazy stories about girls like that I dated.
Well, you're way cooler than us.
No, but I just think that what I think is that guys play games with girls.
100%. Okay. And as someone that has played games and lied, that was not this situation. We were having a great time.
Because you can be upset, right? But I think that to go to that extreme where it's like, nigga, I'll kill both of us. Like, what did you do? Like, what is your role in this? Look emotion.
At you, look at you victim blaming me.
No, right. I'm not victim. I'm just talking about
look
in general.
In the mirror,
like,
what did you
what
do?
Would make what would make a girl that upset to where it's to a point like you're driving on the freeway.
Okay.
You're doing 75.
Uh-huh.
And she thinks that I'm gonna just grab this wheel and we're gonna go right into this divider.
So what you're saying is you think women manage their emotions really well.
Some do.
Well, how about Angelina Jolie?
Well, what I will say, Maul, I will say is if anybody does that, they have mental health issues of their own. But men be knowing women have mental health issues and will still date them and fuck with them and then call them crazy when they finally have an emotional reaction to something. But you knew I was a little off when you started dating me, but you thought, it was well.
Man,
I didn't. Listen. No, I didn't. You didn't show me till this moment.
Oh, I didn't show you until I almost took the fucking car off the highway. That was crazy.
I'm not rolling. I think it's a buildup. It's something before that. It doesn't start at grabbing the steering wheel.
People don't snap?
Damaris, sometimes it is just like a moment.
Sometimes, but how often?
I don't know.
I mean, we're talking about those moments right now.
If I get to the point where I'm trying to snatch the fucking steering wheel out your hand while we're on the fucking freeway, you knew I was crazy. There was a red flag. There was a crazy red flag.
It's a lead up.
What if it's the first red flag?
Thank you.
No. Right. That's never
no,
the first
because sometimes it's explosive. There's like microaggressions and people build that thing. And then you think everything's cool because they've been leading with cool. And then there's that one like boom. And you're like, what the fuck? That could have been the boom.
I don't think I understand there's a boom. I don't think grabbing the steering wheel is the first boom.
Okay.
Though.
Why
like,
not?
The first boom the is maybe like boom? Walking into the kitchen and finding like the knife in the middle of the cake. That's got to be like the first one. Like
that's the breadcrumbs and flour too.
Yeah, like this bitch is crazy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Or like going into the bathroom and like she goes to take a shower and she comes out fully dressed. It's like, yo, you got dressed in the bathroom?
That was
like,
a very specific.
Mall, that's very specific.
Yeah, that's crazy, right? If you see a girl going to the bathroom and take a shower, she comes out fully dressed, like, this bitch is crazy.
Wait, why?
Or she got a rash.
A rash? Nah, we not doing
that. A rash?
We not doing the rash. You not gonna tell me you got dressed because you got I saw the rash at some point.
Yeah. Well, no, the lights were out.
We had sex in the dark. I went in the bathroom, got dressed.
Yeah, but I'm rubbing on you. I feel alligator skin, B. Turn the light on. If I feel eczema, turn the lights on.
Sometimes it's under the skin.
If I feel eczema, turn the lights on, my nigga.
Yeah. Alligator skin is sick.
You not about to just pop eczema up on me in the middle of sex, my nigga. Like, if I'm rubbing on you in the dark and I feel eczema, I'm turning the lights on just to make sure it's eczema. I have eczema.
You gonna keep fighting.
What you mean?
We gonna keep
fighting. No. I gotta see. Let me make sure that's what I think
Rory
it is.
Rory will power through anything.
Yeah. He's crazy. But this is what I'm saying. You can't tell me that grabbing the steering wheel was the first, like,
ambitious people like myself.
Red flag. No. That was the first
red flag. Them red flags be looking real pink and Valentine's Day-ish.
Oh, like your outfit?
When you...
Ooh.
You do look like love.
I love a red flag.
I know.
They're just beautiful in the wind.
In the wind.
Like nothing right? Nothing flies better than a red flag.
You're right. A red kite, if you will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A red what?
What? What's wrong with you, bro? You all right?
What are you going through? Very innocent, looking for a relationship, friends. Mm-hmm. Was also why I needed a third arm to do anything.
Yeah.
Bring up the arm.
I had tapped Kia a few times of like, hey, I dirty macked. I was dirty macking on my own friends throughout the entire party.
Why though?
Because some of Kia's friends are just so innocently minded and like, that dude's going to ruin. He's going to ruin her life.
Yeah, but you don't.
He's going to ruin. No, I can see it in her eyes. She's looking at him. They're going to fuck tonight.
Yeah,
and
but
Jesus Christ.
And he is not going to text her back.
Yeah, but Rory, you don't go into the forest and when a guy has a fucking a baby deer in the crosshair and say, hey, guy, not that one.
Not that.
Yeah. Like, I know that's what I was doing.
You let you don't say, hey, listen.
No,
not
I'm
that
shooting
one.
Bail.
You let nature take its course, man.
She had a sniper on her crew too, and I saw it.
She had a female.
Sniper. Oh, no. Kia has snipers. Crew. I was trying to defend the snipers off of the ones that are Army Reserves. Oh, they don't even go to battle.
You can't call female snipers.
No.
There's a word for female snipers.
Stuff.
I'm not going to say
there's it. There's a word for male snipers too. It doesn't matter. They still snipers.
Yeah. Cool. The man.
Yeah. Female snipers are not snipers. We know what they are. Let them be that. I'm not going to say it though.
There is a such thing as a female sniper.
What's okay. Whores.
Yeah, whores. That's what we were getting at.
I was trying you, to, you know.
Are you okay? What the fuck is wrong with you?
Yeah, like, being a whore. No, I'm out of it today.
I've been really
like
slow.
Like your curls are not curled all the way over. Your fucking bang is not banged.
I was trying to think of an equivalent in the army world. And then I was like, oh no, just whores.
In the army world.
And I spent all day yesterday throwing up. It's been a shitty run for me.
Oh, you hungover?
A female sniper.
No, I'm not hungover. I just had a stomach bug.
You know what, Damaris? I knew she was a sniper, and I'm sure we're talking about the same girl.
Which girl?
Uh-huh.
She had ass?
But I had to respect.
It's a great follow-up.
Did she have ass? Y'all not answering the
question. I don't even know.
I've never looked. I don't.
Damaris, you don't know if she had ass or not?
I wasn't looking at her.
Yeah, honestly.
Gay. You're going to look at a woman's ass.
Not all women.
Oh, what? So does she?
She gets surgery, so she might have. I just really don't look at her body.
Yeah, I wasn't looking.
Oh, that one.
This is how I know. I didn't respect her gun. Like, I knew she was a sniper.
You.
Yo, if you would. We all know Loyon, right?
was he here?
Loyon was at
and
the party?
I'm not here to. Was
he was here?
Docks?
Loyon was at the party.
Yeah. Oh, yo, I know.
You know, he was fitted up.
He was
laying on his stomach. With
Nah.
Ass up.
Loyon's a no-scoper.
Yeah, he just
shoot from the hip.
He just picks up a blade of grass, watch the wind take it. He's like, oh, I know what to do with this one.
Why I respect this young woman's sniper game.
I love
and I should have respected it more is I know the type of guys that she snipes. And once she learned about like Loyon's pedigrees, for those that don't know, he's our business manager, my financial advisor. He's the GOAT. Once she found out like his resume.
He's the money man.
I've never seen her snipe someone like Loyon before. And she was in that corner getting to work.
Going crazy.
While Ignition was playing. Going to work.
I like that. I like girls that step to their business like that.
Nah, she said, wait, he does what? All right, but.
That's how it be though. That's how it be though.
Yeah, I know.
Fuck what a nigga look like. What are you on? What do you do?
First of all, Loyon's an attractive man. Don't do that.
Oh, no. Loyon's gorgeous.
Like. That's crazy. That he listens to this podcast.
See, that's something that men will never say.
He sends you your check,
fuck
by the
she
way.
She look like.
He's the one that wires
fuck
you.
Out here. Everybody know Loyon's my favorite team member, and I love Loyon. Loyon's
fuck what
gorgeous.
He look like. A man could never say, yo, fuck what she look like. Like
y'all do that all the time. What the ass look
who's
like?
Who's y'all?
Y'all do that all the time.
Man,
you just told me you fucked an ugly bitch. You just told me that the other day you fucked an ugly bitch.
When I was like 18, 19?
But you said about her ass was fat.
How old was I?
I don't know.
I wasn't a man yet. I was a fucking lost boy in the fucking streets of the Bronx trying to find my way back home.
The fuck? A lost boy in the Bronx is
great movie.
Ayo.
Yeah. How's that an Ayo? Talk about
why was you lost? What was you doing?
Where you was going? Who you was following?
Ass.
That's fair, I mean.
Yeah. Not man ass, so don't try to make it gay. See, look at you.
Well, they get BBL, so you never know. It could be.
Stop, man. Don't do
it. So we stayed, like after everyone left, a few of us stayed in the office till pretty late, just kicking it.
Kicking it, right?
And after I had tried to dirty mac for so long, my dirty macking did not work.
Nope.
That girl was open and ready to go. And I had to ask my friend,
can you not fuck her? Because it's going to interrupt my life.
Who, what, can you bleep? Who was
no,
the guy?
No, we'll talk about it after.
You don't know. Maul probably knows him. He's from Harlem. Everyone in Harlem knows everybody. Yeah, 7th Ave, you know.
His name is Street.
How I go. He from 7th. I know that, nigga.
The sniper on
7th. A sniper on 7th. I know that, nigga. He got like 40 bodies on something. I know.
He's the dark-skinned guy with the greatest smile. He's charming, tall, like everything. It's hard to resist when a young white girl that has never seen,
never had that,
seen that before.
She never had chocolate in her diet before.
And I just, was it wrong of me to ask him that? Like, just please don't fuck her. Because it's going to come back to me. We blended worlds. And if you start fucking Kia's friends, I know him. There, no relationship.
Nah,
he was not going to text her the next
morning. We grown.
I don't need that in my life.
We grown.
So he didn't do it?
It'd be different if he was pursuing something with her.
He says no, but I don't know.
Then you can say, like, if he's pursuing something with her, then you can't say, please don't do that. Because if he's actually pursuing something, you might be...
You grown.
No, what I'm saying is he can't say that because it's like he might be looking for love. And if he's looking for love, she's looking for love, it might work out. You don't want to keep somebody from their soulmate.
No, he's not looking
for love. But if not looking...
He's looking for head.
If he's looking for head, then no, you can say don't do that. Because you're not even really looking for it to be a long-term thing.
He's looking for that sloppy neck. He asked me if this part of the studio was soundproof.
That's
while we were all in the front room.
No, he didn't.
He was stupid.
He's a nigga that can never come back here again. When niggas start asking questions,
he's actually a really, really nice guy.
Yeah, but when niggas start asking questions like that, it's like, yo, what you trying to get off in here?
Oh, Rory was going crazy. Rory was telling everybody business, telling trap secrets to motherfuckers.
Wait.
I look over, niggas giggling. They like, yo, Damaris, she was fucking in the studio. I'm like, what?
Oh, yeah. I did
see. We just had a conversation about not having parties here in the workplace, not having alcohol, and y'all just... See?
It was, first of all, it was a kid's birthday.
It's alcohol.
The R. Kelly theme.
It's alcohol in the hallway on the floor.
Oh, no, there's plenty of alcohol.
Oh, exactly. See?
You think we was about to listen to some screaming-ass kids sober?
They found the rubber chickens, too, so that was...
And they decapitated all of our rubber chickens.
A lot of noise.
What kid decapitated? That's the little kid you need to watch. He's
all
the school shooter.
All of them.
No, he's the school shooter in training.
Britt's son, actually.
Oh, yeah. He's the school shooter in training.
X is not a school shooter.
X is not a school shooter.
Shit. Okay. Man, like,
you just find chickens in a random place and you just start popping the heads off. Watch that kid. He's telling you something. You know what kids come home, they have a drawer. Yeah, Judas today, mommy. And then he's holding you and daddy's head like this. Watch that. Watch that little nigga. Something ain't right with him. Like,
the sweetest.
I don't know what to tell you. Like, a kid comes in here, finds rubber chickens, and he pops the heads off. Yeah, watch him. He go to the bathroom. I'm right by the door waiting for him to come out. What you was doing in there?
And there's matchbooks all over this office.
Well, because you was doing your magic trick.
Could have been playing with fire.
Yeah.
So, anyways, I just didn't want him to fuck Kia's friend.
No, you grown. Let them fuck.
No.
They're grown. They're adults.
I'm not trying to make a you haven't been in a relationship joke before, but sometimes when
you're
in a relationship and your friends fuck your girl's friends.
So what?
And don't talk to them anymore.
So what?
It ends up being part of your life.
No,
you have to hear about it.
That's when you tell your girl, yo, your girl is a grown woman. I'm not talking about this in my household. That's your friend is how old? She's a grown ass woman.
No, I'm trying to create a peaceful environment.
It's peaceful.
They're both adults. They both wanted to fuck each other, but
exactly.
I don't want the fucking.
That's not your problem.
Rory's birthday is in May. Now, what if we throw a party for Rory? Then they both there. Then shit awkward.
They're grown adults. Y'all can get the fuck out of here with that weird shit.
I think you're missing.
Y'all, two adults chose to fuck.
They're consenting adults that want to fuck.
Exactly.
I'm saying I don't want the headache because I know the result of this.
And I'm telling you,
going to be that girl looking up at him like,
bro,
how come he's not texting me back? Because that's who he fucks women and keeps him moving. He's a very honest human being.
Well, Rory, why didn't you tell us that? Why didn't you keep him from? Because now her heart broke.
Yeah, I didn't because you're grown and that's none of my fucking business. How about that? And I'm not sitting in my household talking about that. I'm feeding my daughter right now. Everybody shut the fuck up.
I have no arm.
You got to take your nuts, Rory, and swing the motherfuckers around your living room sometimes with no drawers on. That's what you got to do. Let them know, listen, I got two big Spaldings under these motherfucking boxes and I'm not talking about this today. My friend fucked your girl because that's what two adults wanted to do. They wanted to fuck. Now, don't bring that to my fucking house because now she's crying because he didn't fucking call her after dropping that pipe off in her. That ain't got nothing to do with me. All right? Baby Shark is on.
Clip it.
Yo.
Go ahead, Mal.
What the fuck you mean? That's a part of my religion. No, it's not.
Too Spalding.
Take your fucking nuts, pull your boxes up here and show the motherfuckers if you
First of all, my nuts were clipped January 30th, 2023. I lost any bit of control I've had in my life. My household is run by women.
Yo, you
it's only women in there.
Nah, but
it's my mom, Kia, and Amara.
Nah, you still got.
I had lost my nuts.
Nah, man.
You got so long ago.
You are Irish. Go back, dig into your roots, all right? Have a fucking Heineken, a fucking Guinness. Guinness, and fucking drag your nuts around your house. Yeah, he fucked your friend, and yeah, she's crying. She's gonna make her a better woman, though. She ain't gonna do it again, right? She's an adult. She's a grown-ass woman. She wanted to fuck. He wanted to fuck. They fuck. He didn't call her no more. She's crying. Why am I talking about this?
Because it's my friend.
Say you did the thing where you tried a dirty Mac and they still went home and fucked. And then he did what he was going to do. Not talk to her or see her again. Then what? Do you still feel away?
I didn't dirty Mac to her. So it wasn't. I dirty Mac'd with Kia and I dirty Mac'd him to his face of like, don't. Please don't fuck.
It was Kia's job to tell her friend that, hey, he ain't shit. That kind of falls on her.
But what's kind of funny is Kia was more on Mal's side. If they gonna fuck, let him fuck. I'm like, all right, cool. When she texts both of us in our group chat, I'm not replying. Like,
dude, you chat with men all day online and flirt.
No, Rory, that doesn't make you gay.
Okay. Come on, Rory.
We have to be a progressive world.
What do you think Thanksgiving's
back
like?
In 2000, you would have been gay, gay, gay.
Now you're a hero.
Yeah, there you go.
And I think they are.
Yeah.
But, that's a fun Thanksgiving conversation. Like, when you have to talk to your family about your job.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were about to say when you have to come out the closet.
Well, that too. I mean, yeah, that's at Thanksgiving.
I'm sure that's not that fun.
You ever been like around like family and then somebody like in your family came out and then everybody was like, well,
I have a cousin that's
we've been
still
knew
in
you were
closet.
Gay, bro. That's still in the closet?
Dude, he's older than I am. We're just like, come on, dude.
Have y'all said it to him though? Like,
we all know. I mean, he's like, not that this is like all gay guys do this, but like, he's like the theater guy. He
He goes to Broadway shows.
He acts.
Oh,
when we were younger, he's like the karate. He does all the splits. Like, it's just, he's that.
I'm not gonna lie, doing a split.
I'm not gonna lie, dude. Like when we were,
Come
on, in 2023, but like,
the splits is athletic. In 2000, he's gay, gay, gay. It's 2023, so he's just athletic. All right.
He's father. We get a pep talk before any holiday. For one of my cousin Ryan is gay. I went to the courthouse for his wedding. I went to his wedding. I love him to death. But my mom, for some reason, has to give me the pep talk. No gay jokes. Don't use the F word. I'm like, mom, I would never fucking do that. Like, why do you keep saying that?
Parents try to give you the conversation not to like have gay jokes around your cousin. It's hilarious.
Then I get more so like, I talk to him more than you do. I should be giving you this fucking talk.
And it's like your mom, like she
that's
wants-
That's my man. You just see him on Thanksgiving.
I
see him often.
Yeah, like we kick it.
I was at the wedding. Where were you?
Right, exactly. I mean, it's just, you know when you have a family member or friend, somebody that's gay.
But like, it's offensive because actually, I guess my uncle, his father would probably care.
And also, you getting these gay jokes.
Like, yeah, for sure.
Everyone
gets joked out on
listen,
holidays.
Man,
you getting gay jokes because I love you.
I love everybody. I don't care about your sexuality.
If I'm not comfortable joking enough like that with you, then that means we're probably not close.
Yeah, we're not cool. We're not cool. And if you my family, you definitely getting, if we related, you definitely, but you know that you're getting these jokes. Like, you can't, like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, that's the thing. It's like, you know, the world paints it as if you joke on people because of their sexuality, it's a hurtful thing. I'm like, no, it's not.
No.
Like, if I go outside and see a random couple that I don't know and I start doing that, that's crazy.
Yeah.
But if my cousin walks in here and he's with his boyfriend,
what would you say?
And I start lighting them up, like, they know I love them. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we family. You know what I'm saying? But y'all gonna get these jokes. Just like if my hetero relatives walk in, they getting jokes too.
Yeah. I mean, hey, all right.
You know what I'm saying?
Some it's like hetero jokes.
Everybody's getting these jokes.
Some classic hetero jokes.
Yeah, like which are calling them gay.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, if your cousin that's straight walks in with his girlfriend and they're matching, like, oh, y'all are gay. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Like,
that's
like the meet and greet couples with the same shoes.
Yeah, it's like, what type of gay? What are y'all doing? Like, and then you're looking at the dude and he wants to say, like, I know this is so gay for me to do.
It's probably his
like,
idea.
Listen, and the first time my cousin brought his now husband, but boyfriend at the time, to, I want to say it was Thanksgiving, Christmas. My mom, the moment the boyfriend walked in, she was like, don't make any jokes. I was like, I was going to make an Indian joke, not a gay joke.
That's crazy. That's wild.
I wasn't going to make a gay joke. I was going to make an Indian joke.
Yeah, man. I mean, you know, people just, it's 20. Like I said, the fact that people feel like they can't be themselves in 2023 speaks to how crazy this world is. Like,
yeah.
Who fucking cares? I don't know. People should not care about someone's sexuality. It's, be happy. It's do whatever world, you want as long as you're not touching kids or, you know, sexually abusing anybody. If it's consenting adults, right. It's all good. And Fauci.
Ed, have you ever messaged anyone on 23andMe?
No.
So I haven't gotten any replies yet, but my favorite thing to do lately is say, hey, see, we're family. Can I borrow some money? And no wow. one has.
I like that.
Yeah, I get
like
it.
Literally the fourth cousins. I just go down the list, copy paste.
Yeah.
Like, I'm waiting to see if maybe there'll be one person that's
somebody
like,
that's like a billionaire.
Yeah.
I say, hey, what do you need? I send a wire right over.
The wire.
Yeah. The wire.
Like, I got you, cuz.
Yeah. What do you have? We're family? Oh, are you kidding me? Come on, man. You got to come to the palace one day.
Yeah. I don't want to meet other family members.
Oh, I don't either.
I don't know why that
happened. I just want to see if anyone will reply to my money request.
You want to meet like family that lives in other parts of the world?
No.
That's like really blood family?
But it's like awkward because like you don't
I'm
know.
I'm not even
them.
Big on like, the ones I know.
You know, big on the ones that's in Queens right now. Like
my dad was just here high on shrooms being a menace.
That sounds cool. God.
I'm so mad I left early that day and missed your dad, bro.
He was staring at Damaris like, we may have a HR problem.
Oh, my God.
Because this was technically the workplace.
Oh, God.
I mean, it is. Yeah.
He was looking at Damaris. He wanted some chocolate.
Well, he wanted some chocolate, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
What'd you say about Roy's head? Yeah.
Big old black ass. Oh, big old black ass. Nigga.
But that was Rory.
Nigga.
Was it on Patreon? Didn't we go through some of my family members and looked at their avies on who like looked pretty racist?
Yeah, tell them all.
I still feel like really, really, really bad.
What happened, man? Well, first of all, happy birthday to Amara.
If you're listening to this on Tuesday, her birthday is today.
Yes.
We did the party over the weekend at the office. So a friend of ours, who you know, also part of the team,
mm-hmm.
brought her boyfriend to Amara's birthday party, which was great. I've met him before. He's a really nice guy. He has one arm.
A friend.
Writers.
Oh. Hold on. Let's slow down. A friend of ours that is a part of the team bought their boyfriend, and her boyfriend has one arm.
He has one arm.
Gotcha. Go ahead.
Nice guy. Met him before.
Okay.
It's good to see him.
Yeah.
It was very overwhelming.
Lefty or righty?
Well, what you asked?
The left arm is missing.
Yeah, he didn't have the left.
He can only be a righty.
Okay, so he's a righty.
Well, he didn't have a choice.
Okay, got it.
Going in for the handshake was kind of nice, though, because he had the arm that you shake. So it was like, this is easy.
It's helpful.
It's all you need.
Yeah, it was very helpful.
Yeah.
So at this party, very overwhelming. There's like 20 kids running around screaming. I'm trying to get pizza in. Like, it's just a lot going on.
All right, how did he lose the arm? Was he like, was it a boating accident? Was he in Afghanistan? Is he like a patriot? Is he a veteran?
I don't know. He wasn't wearing his Purple Heart.
All right. So he wasn't in Nam.
No.
All right. I'm sorry, man. Go ahead, man. I mean, listen. I'm that guy.
No one was like,
I'm asking.
You lose that in the Gaza Strip? Like no one. Yeah. It wasn't a topic of conversation at Amara's birthday party.
Okay.
Anyway,
my bad.
So, our friend and her boyfriend are leaving and trying to say goodbye. I have Amara in one arm and a pizza.
All right, I already see what's going on.
That's what I said.
I don't even want to.
I have a pizza box in the other.
So now,
I'm in the middle of something, and they're trying to say goodbye because they're good friends.
So now he has more arms than you with them.
Then I said to him when they were both going for like a hug and a dap to say goodbye. I said, "Sorry, I don't have any arms," which he then replied with, "Me too."
I like that guy. Really.
That's funny.
My type of guy right there. It's my type of guy. Address the awkward shit. Let's laugh at it and move on.
No, but you...
Give me a beer.
You don't understand.
Rory was
the color
purple.
Yeah. Like, my face went whiter than it is now because I just realized I said to somebody with one arm straight in their face, I don't have any arms.
This 5 seconds of inconvenience in my life, I'm going to let you know. You literally are missing it up.
I would have said that to anyone. I was trying to do shit like
I get it. I understand.
Someone's tried to dab you, like, yo, I ain't got any arms. No hands.
But
like,
you in that
you
moment.
You said, look, my no hands.
But like, you have to understand, in the middle of the chaos, like, everything, it went quiet in my brain. Mm. And it was just us in the room. And I'm staring at someone with one arm. And I just said to them, I don't have any arms.
Mm-hmm.
Did you say my bad? Like, after, or you just,
I froze? I froze.
And I'm going to tell you what, Rory's
and then I watched them walk to the elevator.
I'm not bailing Rory out. Rory's a dick. He knew what he was doing.
No, I
didn't. Because you don't say, in that situation, you don't say, I don't have any arms.
It could have just been like,
you say, I don't have any, I don't, Rory has never said, I don't have any arms. You don't say, I don't have any arms. You say, yo, my hands aren't free. Like, I have, my hands are full. You don't say, I don't have any arms. Who says that?
Me.
Often. Yeah, to somebody with one arm, because you're a dick. That's exactly what you would say. Rory has never said, with a hand, we done traveled the world together, had carry-on luggage, then had microphones, all kind of cameras, equipment and shit. Rory has never said, yo, I don't have any arms.
Because I wasn't trying to dap you at TSA.
No, you say my hands are full. That's what you're supposed to say. My hands are full. You don't say, I don't have any arms. He knew what he was doing, bro. I'm not letting him get that off. He knew what he was doing.
Subconsciously, maybe, because I did not intentionally. I can maybe go with your theory that subconsciously in my head,
you were a dick.
That happened.
Of course. That's what it
is. But I did not intentionally tell a man with one arm that I don't have any arms.
Subconsciously, you told him that. You thought it.
I mean, well,
you didn't think it right
there.
It's
hard to miss.
No, you didn't think it right there in that moment, but throughout the day, it was in your mind. You was writing material. He was writing material. I don't. That's the type of guy Rory is. He's gonna write material. He don't know when he's gonna deliver it, but he's gonna write it.
Get up on your good arm.
Yeah, come on, man.
I was reading Nikki tweets. That's why.
Exactly.
I was definitely out of helmet. So I don't fuck around with shit that I'm not too familiar with, like snowmobile. And I'm like, nah, this would be how Maul go out, and I'm not going out on the snowmobile. So I had the helmet and everything on, but it was cool though. It was a real. It was a dope experience, man. Just seeing like the scenery, being in the forest, going like around the trees and all of that shit. Like, it's really, but it does get scary after a while, because you're like, yo, what if the tour guide decides, like, you know what? I quit and just leaves. And it's like in the middle of the fucking, like, nobody is there. And then they make you take like they make you take pictures before you go into the trail in case they have to have a search and rescue. He tried to make it seem like it's not weird. Like, he's like, hey, just jump around. Like, no, I'm going to stand here so you can see exactly who I am in case y'all need to come find me.
How long do you think you'd last? You were layered.
Maul versus the wild.
It wasn't, and the thing is, it wasn't that cold.
Into the Wild featuring Maul.
Oh, shit. Like, if the snowmobile broke down?
You are Chris McCandless.
Yeah. You get stuck. You don't have cell service. You're just in the wild, stuck. How long do you last? in those conditions, winter, snowy conditions.
I don't know, man. It wasn't that cold because it was the daytime, so some sunlight was out. But I know when the sun goes down, it gets cold. I was layered. I had gloves. I had a big coat, had the pants, everything on, boots. But I don't know, man. I don't know how long I would last, like, with no water, no
food.
You
got snow right there, though.
Yeah,
you just got to melt the snow. Throw it on your
maybe
armpit.
A day.
You okay. Give it a day?
A day.
All right, let's say you
because I would walk until I couldn't walk no more. Like, I'm going to try to
but
walk.
Then that sock's going to get wet.
No, right. But I had like the high snow boots on.
You had 40 belows on in Denver?
Yeah, I had the 40. Yeah, I had.
You had the mischief boots on?
Yeah, no.
Okay, at what day do you break your veganism?
Day one.
Yeah, probably the first sign of But no, I don't, because I don't think you would. I would be that hungry.
Can we table this too as an idea? Like,
to leave me in the wild?
No, well, that too.
The fuck?
It's punked.
No, it's not.
Rory's punks just want to hurt Maul.
Yeah, bro.
But a vegan going into the wild, at what point, and let's talk about like the stomach issues. As someone that eats a bunch of meat, if I had to like kill a wild boar and cook it, I'm going to cook it wrong. It's still going to fuck my stomach.
I like the now fact that Rory thinks that he can just Maul. Kill a wild boar.
Yeah.
Like, no, your bare hands?
Yeah.
Look at his hat. Look at his hat.
Look at my hat.
Just give him one swift right.
Look at his hat. He looks like a fucking
put
narc.
The brass knuckles on. Just like fucking
Maul, I'm scared of bees.
A wild boar?
Yeah, he's fighting it like this.
That's what I was mad that we didn't see. I wanted to see
a muskrat. I wanted at what point
muskrat? Muskrat is hilarious.
You've been vegan for a long time. What if the first meal you had to have was an uncooked muskrat that was just like scurrying through the snow?
Yeah, I would probably die from just throwing up and just shitting.
They
myself.
Said rabbits are common.
Yeah, rabbits are
to
common.
Eat. You could probably. Eat
I'm
a
not
rabbit.
Catching a rabbit. I don't. You can't even catch a fucking
catching a rabbit.
You can't catch a fucking rabbit.
You build like a trap.
Maul can't build a trap.
Build a trap.
He wants to make the wilderness Home Alone.
movies. I've worked in a trap. I can't build a trap.
They caught Joe Pesci. They can get a rabbit.
What the fuck are you talking about? Build a trap. Like, who do you think with no type, I'm just going to take shit from scratch and just build. No, I'm not that guy.
If you had like a wire in your ear with Bear Grylls in your ear telling you how to get shit done, you think you could then do it?
Yeah.
If I had somebody like talking me through it, I definitely have a better shot.
Not there with you to help, just someone in your ear giving you instructions on how to get stuff done. You think?
I would definitely try, but like just nothing, and I'm just out there. I wouldn't know what. I'm from the city, bro.
But you'd have a lighter on you because it's you. So that's a step up.
Oh, that's true.
And you'd beat me in that category. I wouldn't have a lighter on me.
That you always carry.
I would a day. I already told you how long I would last. One day.
But you don't die in a day. Like you'd have to. You'd live longer than that. You would live longer than a day.
You would live longer than that. I know you've lost some weight, but you got some meat on your bones. Yeah, no, eat away.
I would definitely.
You'd give 3 for 4.
But I'm thinking about the cold. That's what y'all not thinking about, the cold.
You hate being cold.
But you got the 40 belows on. I'm sure you had a Carhartt fit on.
That shit is still cold, though. It was still very, you could tell like when the sun goes down, it's fucking freezing out there. Right. But it was beautiful, though. Like you could see it just the mountains and the sun. Like it was just a beautiful, beautiful place to like just chill. Like we stopped, we took pictures. Like it was a whole, like bunch of us, like just, it was like a group. And then one dude, he went off the trail. He had his girl with him. I said, I know she thinks he's a pussy. Mm.
What? Why?
Because like it's a trail. And if you go off the trail, it's like, the snow is very deep. So the snowmobile kind of just like sinks into the snow. Like it's, so they have to come pull you out. So it's like, how did you even go off the course? Like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
If you were with a young lady, which I know you weren't. I know it was a solo trip to find yourself. Yeah, understand.
No, it was a few of us. It was like six people.
You know, vacation trips.
The Rockefellers.
Would you give consent for people to eat your body?
No.
Really? That's a really selfish move, I feel like.
I mean, you don't really have much of a choice.
If I'm dying first, I'm going to be like on my last breath, like, go for the thigh.
No. No, I want you.
There's
to leave
more
me.
Meat on my ass. No,
eat my ass.
I'm not sure if he was telling us to go fuck ourselves or to eat his ass.
It's like the Donner Party.
All right,
I'm telling you now.
You don't know that.
I want to live. And if we were all as a crew in the woods and you guys started to die, and Maul had a lighter to make fire.
Okay, scenario.
Ed and we could feast for the year.
We're camping. Maul's made it clear he's dying first.
Yeah.
So of all of us, Maul's dying first. Who's going to be the one to dismember Maul and cook him?
Me, probably.
But that's been your fantasy. That's not for survival.
Yeah.
You've had the thoughts, but in a sexual way.
I would kill Ed first. I would just choke him like, don't fight it. Just choke him out. like, listen, you're dying. Yeah, like.
It's been an honor. All right,
who's been in honor as I'm killing him?
Who would eat the thigh that has the tattoo on it?
No, y'all gotta come around and like black people do the birthday cake with the picture.
Yeah, I don't wanna.
That's hilarious. Yeah, we gotta save this part.
Yeah. That's how we know they know it was edited.
Yeah. Why do people say that? It sits in your fridge for 3 days and then you throw it out.
The cake?
The art part of the cake.
That shit is the nastiest piece of cake ever. That shit all hard.
It doesn't taste so good.
Okay, so Maul and Eden die first. No, I wanna go through this. Maul and Eden die first. And then
why
what? Because you're dying with Maul. He's killing you.
Oh, that's an honor.
Then Maul dies.
It's like Romeo and Juliet.
I'm Juliet.
Jack and
then
Rose.
What? The four of us are left. What happens next?
Y'all kill Daenerys next.
Can I say what I would like to happen next?
Yes. You want me to die, Maul.
Yeah, I want Julian to die. That's what I want Julian to do.
I think I'll be all right.
I think I would, at that point, I would kill myself because I feel like Julian would be like, yeah, like my buddy knows the owner of the Rockies.
I'd be out.
Like my brother knows the guys that own the helicopter tour. They're like 30 miles from us. They'll be here in no time.
Yeah, like one of my friends knows someone that plays for the Nuggets. Like, let me see if I can get
in Denver.
Oh, I thought we were in Denver.
No,
we wouldn't be in this scenario. We were in Denver.
Well, you know, we're the outskirts of Denver.
No, it was really fun though, man. We definitely should take a trip like that though. That would be like.
We got you on Grammys, but your flow's still a no. Sure. With a fiasco loop back, future man, you pack. She wanna party with the baby while rubbing her cherry top. I guess she need the money bags for the chains on. She cheated, calm, and the core for. And why the fuck they put the money?
What the fuck
it's
is
hilarious.
That?
Wait till you see it. It's fucking crazy.
What is going on? I feel like y'all don't think the world is a simulation, seriously. Y'all don't think like there's somebody with a joystick above all of us controlling us, like
the aliens.
Yeah, some people say God, but you know.
I would say the Jews.
There's no way this world is real. There's no way. Like this is not a real experience we're having.
It's just another dimension of another dimension of another dimension of a thought of another dimension.
Isn't he?
It's
kind
of like when you look at yourself in the mirror and some mirror behind you, and you can see yourself and yourself behind you.
This is just one layer of a bigger thought.
Ah,
got much bigger thought. That's why we really don't matter that much.
We don't.
Like, as much as I'd love to say that Dre is pregnant. Oh, hey, Patreon, welcome back. We're here. Apologies for the last episode. Things got off the rails.
Why are you apologizing?
Yeah, y'all showed y'all ass when I walked out the door.
That's why we showed our ass, because you walked out the door.
We did go kind of crazy when she left. Even though I was like, at one point, calling socialism communism, which I think they are the same. But it's fine. My point still stood in what I was trying to say.
Yeah.
But I know I was wrong in that way. I just feel socialism has a lot of... Anyways, doesn't matter.
Nope.
It went off the fucking rails. I know some people loved it. I know some people hated it.
They hated you.
But welcome.
They hated me?
Hell yeah.
They hated on Jesus.
Though. Yes. You gotta think about that. There you go. That's why you my dog.
I
love when people hate me. I love that shit.
You got to remember what they did to Jesus.
Yeah.
Anytime somebody hates.
And since I'm made in the image and likeness of Christ himself.
White Jesus.
That means that I'm right on par. There you go. Sure. You know what I'm saying?
There you go. It's been a long episode.
You know me?
Yeah. You know. You were born in Israel?
No, I was born in Beth Israel.
That was a good one.
That was actually great.
I actually don't know what hospital I was born in. I forgot.
Yeah. What?
Look at your birth certificate.
They probably tore it down.
Damn, that I gotta ask my mom.
In the back of that horse and buggy.
Born in a fucking manger.
Damn, I forgot what hospital I was born in. That's crazy.
Some straw grass.
You were searching our truth back in the yard.
How did I arrive?
How did I arrive?
Where did I arrive?
Where do they keep horses? What's that thing called?
In a stable?
Yeah, it was an empty stable.
Yeah.
Your mother knocked on the door.
They call them that too.
Yeah, I gotta call my mom. She's gonna like want to hang up on me because I ask her that probably every like 5 years.
Yeah, because you start with the witch bitches that want to do your birth chart.
Oh no, my mom don't even answer that no more. She be like, stop talking to her. She'll text me back, stop talking to that girl.
Is your birth certificate etched in stone?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's like a slab of concrete somewhere in my mom's closet.
You gotta throw some water on it.
Yeah, to see it. To see it. Like, yeah.
Social security number is only 4 digits.
That's crazy. If your social security number is 4 digits,
you're dead.
Do you guys remember that? What was that theory that white people had like even numbers at the end of their social security number?
Two numbers in the middle are always, when you add them up, it's even if you're black, and it's odd if you're white.
I'm sure there's some mathematical science to it where they're to keep track of people in this regard.
Well, you said the two middle numbers?
Yeah.
If they add up.
If they're an even number when you add them up, you're black. If they're not, that means you're.
Damn, I'm black then.
Mine's
8. If you add mine up,
mine's
8.
6.
Yours is 6?
Yeah. So there goes that theory.
That debunks hard.
I'm as white as they come. 23 of me told me.
Yeah.
Couldn't even get that one like South African percent. Anyways, off mic, they were trying to explain.
No. Is it that or is it an even number?
I think it's bullshit is what I think that theory makes absolutely no sense.
All right. What's your middle numbers?
All right, man.
No, tell me the rest.
Just your middle numbers of your social security? You can't say just the middle numbers? It's like.
It adds up to 6 and. It's
all right,
two
but like, if it's like 51, then there might be some
theory. It's 6 and 0.
Oh, so that's an even number. Okay.
Yeah, I said it added up to 6. And is 0 an even number? Yeah.
Well, 60 is an even number.
There you go.
Yeah.
Well, they were trying to explain to us off mic.
Julian, what the fuck?
Yeah, what are you doing over here?
This thing is, it's annoying me, and I noticed in the last episode.
We had pre-production for this.
Right now while we're recording. It was just necessary.
Thank you.
Hmm.
Is he okay?
I don't know.
Sorry.
Drugs.
It looks a lot cleaner.
I think he might be back off the wagon.
Yeah. You had a little blow night?
No. Stop.
He said stop. That's a stop. Yes.
Yeah, that's a yes.
guys, stop.
So how'd you know? Can you see it in my eyes?
All right, go ahead.
And we're back.
Back into our, ecosystem.
Cap.
And harm us.
Cap? Like polarized cap or just cap?
You think it's cap?
Just go torch that shit. Put some heat to the fucking virus and kill it.
I think the zombie part is just a
that's your response.
Yeah.
Wait, but they're saying
like the thing.
It can come back. When was there the zombie disease before?
Well, it's been frozen for almost 50,000 years.
Also, these are the retro zombies.
But how do they know it's a zombie disease?
It
hasn't thawed out yet.
It goes wrong.
I think you can still sample. I think you can breach the soil, sample it, identify what it is, but then know that it's still frozen and not a threat.
But as temperature rises and the shits, the caps melt, this now becomes a more of a living threat.
This feels like the plot to Jurassic Park to some degree.
I want all of the animals to come back.
Same.
Dinosaurs would be cool.
Yeah, I want all of the dinosaurs.
What animals would you want? All but raptors.
I want a T-Rex. Only because I just need to know what they sound. I feel like we've been lied. I feel like they sound nothing like we've been taught. I feel like they sound nothing like we've been taught.
Yeah.
That's why I want them to come back.
What's the sound? And how would they guess that?
I mean,
like who was there?
Probably the vocal
tracks. They even roar. What if they actually spoke English?
What if they squeaked?
That's why I love that that new video that's going around where they were able to like reenact like a mummy's voice with the mummy sound like.
Oh yeah.
And he's like, "Yo, suck my dick." Yo, I love that. Because it's like, how do you know?
Like, what if a T-Rex was attacking you with a London accent?
Yeah.
That'd be hilarious.
Less threatening, I feel like.
Like, what if they sound like dogs? What if they bark?
Yeah.
Just like, then I'm not really that scared of a T-Rex if it's just barking at me.
Would you rather have the aliens, like, have come back? Or, like, not come back, but, like, occur? Or have dinosaurs back?
Or maybe are coming back.
Well, aliens, I feel like I just want them to come back so they could be like, yo, why y'all calling us aliens? Like, I feel like that's going to be their beef. Like, why y'all calling
us
that?
What if we call the aliens and then bring back the dinosaurs?
The dinosaurs are the aliens. I didn't even think about that. And let me not talk about anything dinosaur related because they destroyed me on TikTok. I think our only viral TikTok was when a gentleman explained to me how the dinosaurs were extinct.
Big rock.
Explosion.
Violated.
He bodied that. Whoever that was, thank you. And do more of that with my dumb takes because it was, he said, big rock.
That's kind of like prioritization. We had to explain prioritization.
Wait, but Rory, what was your take? Why was it stupid?
I was confused how asteroid
listen to this.
Could come and blow up and like kill all the dinosaurs, but like it didn't make their bones evaporate too. Like I feel like an asteroid would just take everything out.
I get that.
Like rarely in huge explosions are there bones. Let alone a full T-Rex that they can piece together in one spot.
So what he's saying is it's kind of like 9/11. Like they couldn't find a plane, but then they found passports.
I'm saying...
It was like, how?
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm saying that jet fuel can't melt T-Rex bones is really what I'm trying to get at.
So he's saying that the 9/11, it was able to melt the black box. They couldn't find it, but they were able to find the passports.
Ah.
Hey, man, why the box got to be black?
It sounds like the asteroid from the Middle East.
That's because we can't be stopped. No matter how much heat you put to us. That's not why they need it.
And that could have just went to a whole... You know, I'm just going to... All right, so Willie Mammoths or whatever the fuck they're called are coming back to... So,
listen. Eden is definitely on the spectrum.
I'm definitely on the spectrum. Yeah.
How you doing, baby? Are you good?
I'm okay. I'm alive.
Whoa.
Damaris is so...
She's dark.
Can we take Damaris?
You see how the hair is laid, though.
Yeah, I know. Something is afoot. She got somewhere to go tonight. She laying the edges down. The edges got to be laid. I know. Where you going, baby D? You got plans tonight? No. Dinner?
Where's he taking you?
No.
Or she?
No plans?
No, I'm going. Or
you have... All right. First of all, the blush, the hair, and the socks all match. You going somewhere.
Y'all hired a professional photographer. I now have to like look decent coming to work. I can't just
give him baby D. Give him who you is. Be yourself. Show your true estate.
The raw.
Your natural state.
Yeah.
That's
if he doesn't love you on the pod, he doesn't deserve you at your
in front of God.
Whatever.
Yeah. Podcast.
Rory, I'm here all week, whether you like it or not.